Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the middle of the month love readings. This is going to be for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Let's get right into your reading, Pisces. Let's see what they have for you for the remaining of the month going into September. Now, your first card here is the King of Pentacles, the Six of Cups, the Ten of Wands, the Ten of Swords, the Two of Wands, and the Ten of Cups. Partners cards is the Ace of Pentacles, the Six of Pentacles, the Devil card here, the Lovers, the King of Wands, and the Star card. Wow, beautiful energy, Pisces. So what I'm seeing directly what they're showing me here with the Ten of Swords, we have two tens. We have the Ten of Wands and the Ten of Swords. This is a culmination. You are going into another cycle in your life where you must embrace new beginnings. And with these new beginnings, stability is going to come forth for you very strongly, Pisces. Now, you may be dealing with an earth sign, Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo. For others of you, you may be dealing with specifically a Capricorn, Gemini, or Aquarius as well. We also do have fire energy here, Sagittarius, Aries, or Leo. But what they're saying here is there is a lot of burden. There's a lot of stress that you're currently dealing with, Pisces. Children could have the center stage right now. What is becoming more important or will be becoming very important for you. It's almost like for some of you guys, it could be having to balance marriage, commitment, career, finances, and being able to have quality time to spend with your family. And that may become a challenge for some of you, in the next coming weeks. However, with two tens here, there is an ending, like I said, a culmination and ending cycle, where stress or even burdens, financial constraints for some of you guys could be greatly affecting the relationship or has been affecting the relationship in the past. So there is, you know, the ending of that struggle, the ending of being able to have enough to make ends meet. For others of you, it could be that your partner perhaps was laid off or hasn't been working as much or hasn't been making what you were making at some point. And that's creating a lot of tension and a lot of stress between you two. However, I do see things progressing in a very positive way. Now, for others of you, I do see, again, like I said, a bit of stress here. But with the Ten of Swords, there is an ending to that. I feel that you're going to be very, like, what's the word I'm looking for? Being very drawn into your partner, almost like relying on them. For some of you guys, you may be going through healing. If you've been sick or if you've been having difficulty with your health, I feel that your partner's going to be putting a little bit more effort in trying to be your emotional support, trying to be the best version of themselves so that they can feel like or think that they are helping you relieve with some of the stress or burdens that you're carrying. And I do see them actively trying. So this is a beautiful energy, like I said. With the Two of Wands here and the Ten of Cups, the struggle or the ending of a struggle is coming to a conclusion for some of you guys. Even, you know, if you've been experiencing having a lot of difficulties with your partner, a lot of arguments, I feel that that's going to be dissipating very quickly coming into the next week and therefore moving forward. There is almost like a bonding that's going to be experienced on both sides. And I feel that there is a need for nurture on both sides. So I do see things progressing in the positive way. Now, how your partner's viewing the situation, with the Ace of Pentacles, I feel that their financial stability starts to stabilize. I feel that for some of them, they're going to be experiencing a lot of opportunities coming their way, that it's going to really help and greatly impact your relationship or dynamic with them. It's like they're going to be more proactive in wanting to help you, wanting to serve you, wanting to, you know, do acts of servitude that you know, help you see really how much they appreciate or how much they care for you. With the Devil card here, there may be some letting go or releasing of some type of toxic trait, whether it's them trying to release themselves or pull away from any like alcohol addictions, pills, any type of drug addiction. It's them really wanting to put the best foot forward and coming to the understanding that they could become better, not only for themselves, but for you as well. Pretty much redirecting and being clear-headed is what I'm hearing. With the Lover's card, a lot of passion is being ignited here, especially because we have the King of Wands. So it's like being very physically attracted to you, being very physically wanting to have that connection on a deeper level, not only physical, but almost a mixture of spiritual as well. So very beautiful energy here with the Star card, being able to see the light at the end of the tunnel. For some of them, it could have been a situation where at some point the passion could have almost felt like it ran out. For some of you guys, maybe not being very sexually active. And the Devil card being here next to the Ace of Wands, the Lovers, and the Star card is definitely talking about going into a cycle where, you know, the desire and the want to be with each other in a physical aspect becomes very powerful, very sexually attracted and being pulled towards each other like magnets. I definitely do see a lot of spicy nights for you coming. So again, there is something that is shifting in the energy where there is a revamping of the way you guys see each other, being more exciting, more spontaneous is the word that I'm hearing. So if in the next coming weeks, even going into the beginning of September, your partner, you know, randomly speaks about going, you know, for a 2-day, 3-day weekend getaway, definitely embrace that. That's their way of trying to refresh and trying to be more spontaneous to be able to ignite the flame within you guys, okay? So very beautiful reading, Pisces. I wish you guys the very best, and we'll see each other soon. Till then, bye.